still trusting. And he's never,
he never failed me yet.
Sing it all. Just the other day, I heard a man say that he didn't believe in God's word. But I can truly say the Lord has made a way, and he's never, never failed me yet. That is why we've come. Trusting in Jesus,
leaning on the Lord.
And I'm still trusting
in His holy word.
And He's never,
He's
never failed me yet. Sing it all. I say another verse. Don't be discouraged when trouble comes in your life. He'll bear your burdens and move all misery and strife. That is why we come. This far by faith, trusting in Jesus,
leaning on the Lord.
And I'm still trusting,
trusting
in His holy word. And He's never, well, sing it all.
Can't turn around. We come this far
from the 100 number of Psalms, where the psalmist pens, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before His presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, He is God. It is He that has made us and not we ourselves. We are His people and the sheep of His pasture. Enter into His gates with thanksgiving and into His courts with praise. Be thankful unto Him and bless His name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and His truth endureth to all generations. This is the day that the Lord hath made, and in spite of 2020, we're going to give God praise. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise.
Would you join me in a word of prayer?
Yeah.
Oh, gracious and kind God, how we thank You, Lord, for bringing us here once again. Lord, we've come by just to say thank You. Thank You, God, for keeping us through all of 2020. Everything hasn't gone our way, but we are just excited to gather once again. We're excited that we're still on this side of glory, Lord, where we can continue to give Your name praise. So we just want to say, God, that you truly are a good God, and you truly are worthy to be praised. You've kept us, God. You've kept our health. You've kept our finances. You've kept our church. God, you've kept our leadership, and we're just coming by to say thank you. Lord, we're asking that you would dance within the aisles of this worship service. Visit us in our respected homes. Allow us to commune with you once again, because as the hour turns from 11 to midnight, it's only because of you that we are still here. So we say you're worthy to be praised. You're worthy to be magnified. And as we anticipate the word of God that will bring us into the new year, we are looking forward to what you will do after this. We know that you are a God who is worthy to be praised. So we magnify you, we love you, and we lift your name on high. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen and amen. Our scripture reading will come from 2 Kings, the 4th chapter. We're going to start at verse 27 and go to verse 35. 2 Kings, the 4th chapter, starting at verse 27 through verse 35. I'll be reading the New King James Translation. And the text reads this way. Now when she came to the man of God at the hill, she caught him by the feet. But Gehazi came near to push her away. But the man of God said, "Let her alone, for her soul is in deep distress, and the Lord has hidden it from me and has not told me." So she said, "Did I ask my Lord for a son? Did I not say, 'Do not deceive me'?" Then he said to Gehazi, "Get yourself ready and take my staff in your hand and be on your way. If you meet anyone, do not greet him, and if anyone greets you, do not answer him, but lay my staff on the child's face." And the mother of the child said, "As the Lord lives, and as your soul lives, I will not leave you." So he arose and followed her. Now Gehazi went ahead of them and laid the staff on the face of the child, but there was neither voice nor hearing. Therefore he went back to meet him and told him, saying, "The child has not awakened." When Elisha came unto the house, there was the child laying dead on his bed. He went in therefore, shut the door behind the two of them, and prayed to the Lord. And he went up and lay on the child and put his mouth on his mouth, his eyes on his eyes, his hands on his hands, and he stretched himself out on the child. And the flesh of the child became warm. He returned and walked back and forth in the house, and again he went up and stretched himself out on him. Then the child sneezed 7 times, and the child's eyes were open. May God add a blessing to the hearers and doers of his holy word. I stand here this evening as well to read the history of Watchnight. It is always nice to understand why we gather, the traditions that we hold so dear. So here's the reading of the history of Watchnight. African American churches in the United States have observed Watchnight since New Year's Eve of 1862. Historically, many African Americans gathered late in the night in churches around the country to watch the new year of 1863 come in. The year that would mark the emancipation of the enslaved in certain states of the South. It should be noted that while the Emancipation Proclamation is often thought of as a document issued by Abraham Lincoln to free the enslaved, the truth is this proclamation was actually an executive order, which only freed certain enslaved persons in certain Southern states, which were then in rebellion against the Union. States that were specifically mentioned in the proclamation include Texas, Arkansas, Louisiana, Alabama, Tennessee, Mississippi, Georgia, Florida, North and South Carolina, and Virginia. The Emancipation Proclamation was issued in September 1862, to take effect on the 1st of January in 1863. So our ancestors gathered in houses of worship and in private homes on the first watch night to watch the dawning of a brand new year. From those uncertain beginnings emerged the tradition of gathering in houses of worship to share songs, testimonies, prayers, and the spoken word of God on New Year's Eve. Watch night services here at the Antioch Church have evolved these some 85 years now. We have gathered as early as 6 p.m. to be in service until midnight. And while we know there is no such magic in the things, we have eaten black eyed peas, cornbread, and ham hocks on the New Year's Eve for supposed good luck that they bring. But tonight we've modified our traditional watch night service. Because of COVID-19, we are unable to gather in large crowds. We're unable to gather for prolonged periods of time here in the sanctuary. Nevertheless, we gather in this small in-house crew in this much larger virtual community to express our gratitude unto the Lord for bringing us through another year, for bringing us through 2020 specifically. While 2020 has been a rough year, God has still blessed us to make it through, and we are indeed grateful. Therefore, we lift our hearts, we lift our hands, we lift our voices in praise and worship and testimony and proclamation, knowing that our God has loosed our shackles and set us free. We also look forward to the greater things than these that will happen as God brings in the new year. We give God glory, we give God glory, we give God glory for the great things he will do in 2021. Amen.
Amen. Let the church say amen. Say amen again. We ought to thank our audio visual team for that great presentation. Y'all, I think it was the second Sunday in March was the last time that we were able to meet together in the sanctuary as an entire church. And when we first adjusted our worship, there was a phrase going around that the church closed. That's what they said, the church closed. But I stand here tonight on Watch Night, the last night of the year, to say to you that the church never closed. And that beautiful collage showed you what your church did this year. And there were a number of things that we did. We just adjusted. The church has never closed. And for that, we ought to give God praise. Matter of fact, what the church did, not only did it not close, it expanded. And he is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy to be praised. I just want to highlight a couple of things. In October, we had a memorial service. In that memorial service, we acknowledged 87 persons who were either members of our church, relatives of members of our church, or friends of our church who passed away during COVID-19. And on that night, that service, we lit a candle for every person who passed away. Since October the 18th, we've had 16 additional deaths in our families, in our church. And a candle will be lit and placed in the vestibule with the name of each and every one of our members who have passed away since October. But y'all, the church didn't close. The church didn't close. We had deaths, but we also had birth. And the Lord blessed us to welcome two new baby bouncing babies into the world in 2020. I'm too old, but to our young folk, you can bring some more in 2021. Amen. And lastly, thank God, even in a virtual environment, we had 41 new members who united with the Antioch Church this year. Y'all, I think we can even do better than that. Y'all, God has been good to the Antioch Church, and we look forward to the great things he will do in 2021. Choir's going to come with the song, and after that, we'll hear a word from our pastor, Reverend Dr. Kenneth R. Kemp.
give up now. Come on, sit down.
I just can't give up now.
I've come too far
from where I'm starting from.
Nobody told me that the road would be easy.
Thank you for bringing those old songs of the church to us tonight. They're not brand new. They're old songs. But sometimes you need to sing some old songs. Some songs that got some meat on them to remind you of how far we have come with the Lord. We've come this far by faith, leaning on the everlasting arm of our Savior. And I just don't believe he brought me this far to leave me now. Will you pray with me? Dear God, in the name of Jesus, we come before your presence now. We thank you for allowing us to come to this point where we see the closing of 1 year and the dawning of another. We thank you for being on our side, for watching over us, for taking care of us despite the pandemic. And Lord, we lift your name and give you praise. Now, as we come to this preaching moment, we pray that you will speak to my heart and speak to the hearts of your people. Hear with my ears, think with my mind, speak with my mouth, Lord, so that your word might go forth. For we need and we desire to hear word from you. So let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. And thank God. I'm going to ask that you would look with me again in 2 Kings, the 4th chapter. We're going to read a few of the verses that precede the culmination of that story that Reverend Mignon just read to us. In 2 Kings, the 4th chapter, I'll give you a little time to find that. It's in the Old Testament. It sometimes hides on you, at least sometimes it hides on me. 2 Kings, the 4th chapter, we're going to read at, let's start at verse 18 and read through verse 26. Hear the word of the Lord. And when the child was grown, it fell on a day that he went out to his father to the reapers. And he said unto his father, my head, my head. And he said to a lad, carry him to his mother. And when he had taken him and brought him to his mother, he sat on her knees till noon, and then died. And she went up and laid him on the bed of the man of God and shut the door upon him and went out. And she called unto her husband and said, send me, I pray thee, one of the young men and one of the asses that I may run to the man of God and come again. And he said, Wherefore wilt thou go to him today? It is neither new moon nor Sabbath. And she said, it shall be well. And she said, it shall be well. Then she saddled an ass and said to her servant, drive and go forward. Slack not thy riding for me, except I bid thee. So she went and came unto the man of God to Mount Carmel. And it came to pass, when the man of God saw her afar off, that he said to Gehazi, his servant, behold, yonder that Shunammite. Run now, I pray thee, to meet her, and say unto her, is it well with thee? Is it well with thy husband? Is it well with the child? And she answered, it is well. Amen. This is the word of God for the people of God. The grass withereth and the flower fadeth, but the word of God shall stand forever. I want to ask that you pray with me and pray for me for just a moment as the Holy Spirit shall lead in the discussion of this theme, prepare for something greater. Prepare for something greater. Well, my brothers and my sisters, it goes without saying that 2020 has been a rough year. From pandemic to poverty to police brutality to political unrest, 2020 has been one for the books. Many of us are ready for 2020 to get out of here. We're expecting something greater in 2021. Therefore, with the Lord's guidance and your prayers and all of your amens, the Holy Spirit has directed me to tell you that on this eve of a new year, you ought to prepare for something greater. The text is an excerpt of the Old Testament story that chronicles the time when the only son of a great Shunammite woman suddenly died. Perhaps you recall that the prophet Elisha had served as God's vessel to bless this woman who had been barren. In his travels to Shunem, the prophet Elijah would often come by her house to break bread. He came by so often that the Shunammite woman asked her husband to build a little chamber on the wall where they put a bed, a table, a stool, and a candlestick to give respite for the man of God when he came their way. She was so kind that Elijah said one day, Gehazi, go get this Shunammite woman so that I might be a blessing to her as she has been a blessing to me. Now when she came to Elijah and stood at the door, he told her, by this time next year, you shall embrace a son. And sure enough, she brought forth her only son in the space of time. And one day when the son became a little boy, he went out to the field where his father was reaping and had a sudden stroke. In fact, he said, my head. His father said to a lad that was with him in the field, he said, take him home to his mother. And there, while upon his mother's knee, the little boy died at about noon. Well, that would be a tragic story if it ended there. But that's not the end of the story. Our text finds this mother determined to prepare for something greater. She laid her son on the man of God's bed and called her husband after she shut the door to give her a donkey and a servant, because she was about to go see the man of God. Her husband was a bit confused, seeing it was not the Sabbath, nor was it the first moon. He was a bit confused. Nevertheless, he provided his wife with what she asked. Brothers, let me just stop there and tell you that's a good thing, to give your wife what she asked for. Now, this great Shunammite woman told the servant, drive and don't stop until I tell you. Now her son had literally died. But it is apparent that in the midst of it all, she was preparing for something greater. Brothers and sisters, there has been literal death in our community in the throes of COVID-19. The life of our loved ones has taken ethereal flight from the mundane earthly existence to the magnificence of heavenly glory. In the process, it may seem like we have been left down here all alone. Yet I suggest to you that it's time to lay 2020 on the bed of our Savior and prepare for something greater. Surely it may seem hopeless, dire, devastating, and disappointing. But I just believe that the God we serve is able to provide something greater after this. Notice what this Shunammite woman did. She laid her son's lifeless body on the bed of the man of God, shut the door, and then called for a donkey and a servant. She didn't go weeping and wailing to her husband, crying, "Our son has died." She just laid her son down on the bed, closed the door, called for a donkey and a servant to inquire of the Lord. You see, what she was doing was setting things in order to prepare for coming glory. She didn't even tell her husband what her true purpose was. She just determined that it was time to go see God through the man of God. Now, I don't recommend that you just go off and leave your husband and your wife and go running off without telling your spouse where you're going and why you're going there. But I do recommend that you set things in order so that you'll be prepared for coming glory. You got to set things in order for when the glory comes. You understand? You got to expect that the glory shall come. So you've got to put your house in order for the coming glory. Now listen. You may miss your blessing if you spend all of your time crying about what you do not have or what you have lost in your life. You may miss your blessing if all you do is pout and ponder and don't stop to pray or praise. Can't you see? It's time for you to set your house in order and prepare for coming glory in 2021. Notice the second thing. I don't want to keep you too long, so let me move hurriedly. Notice the second thing that she did. She told her servant, "Drive and go forward. Don't slack up unless I tell you to do so. Drive and go forward." Whatever the situation may be in 2020, as we approach 2021, you need to drive and go forward. No matter how difficult the situation may be or how hopeless the prospect may seem, just drive and go forward. No matter how much you lost in 2020, drive and go forward. Listen, brother. Pay attention, sister. You got to stop concentrating on what fell out of your hands and give God praise for what you still have in your hands. Drive and go forward. Recognize that the devil, his imps, and all your haters want to see you bent over, broken up, broken down, depressed, and despondent. But do not give the devil his imps or your haters any room in this house. Drive and go forward. It may be dark as you drive, but the darkness comes just before day. It may be late, but it's not too late. It may be hard, but nothing is too hard for my God. Don't slack up, give up, or let up. Drive and go forward. Prepare for the coming glory and then prevail over the negative story, because God has something greater than this. Now notice what happened at the end of the story. She found the prophet at Mount Carmel and she caught him by the feet. We didn't read that verse, go back and read it. She caught him by the feet. Now, please notice that if she caught him by the feet, she had to bow down. Some of the problems we have is that we're too mean and too self-centered to bow down. Well, when Elijah's servant tried to thrust her away, Elijah said, "Leave her alone, for her soul is vexed within her." She went on to tell Elijah what had transpired. And at first, Elijah sent Gehazi to the chamber to lay Elijah's staff on the child. However, nothing happened when Gehazi went in. So he came out saying, "The child has not awakened." Then Elijah himself, the man of God, went into the chamber, shut the door, and began to pray to God. Every now and then, it's necessary to go into the room, shut the door, and call upon the Lord. Every now and then, you've got to go in the room, close the door, and tell the Lord all about it. I tell you, there's healing in the room. There's joy in the room. There's deliverance in the room. Somebody said, "Jesus is my doctor. He writes out all my scriptures. He gives me all of my medicine in the room." Then Elijah laid upon the child. He placed his mouth upon the child's mouth, his eyes upon the child's eyes, and his hands upon the child's hands. And the child's body began to get warm. How many know that sometimes you got to give of yourself in order to bless somebody else? Then Elijah went back into the house, walking to and fro. And finally he went back into the chamber, laid upon the child again, and the child sneezed 7 times, and his eyes flew open. Can't you see that the God we serve is able to raise the dead and allow them to live again? I got to move on, but I wish I had somebody to give God some praise for his ability to lift up a downtrodden head and to raise even lifeless bodies from the dead. I wish you would notice just one more thing. Can I tell you just one last thing? When her husband asked the Shunammite woman in verse 23, "Why are you going to see the man of God?" she responded by saying, "It shall be well." And then when she ran out to meet Elijah in verse 26, and Elijah said to his servant, "Yonder goes that Shunammite woman. Go ask her, is it well with you? Is it well with your husband? Is it well with the child?" She said, while her son was dead and before the prophet came to her house, she responded by saying, "It is well." I guess I shot up here all by myself. While her son was still dead and before the prophet came to her house, she said,
it shall be well. Then she hath the nerve to turn around and say, it is well. Yeah, I need to tell somebody on this New Year's Eve, you must speak things that are not as though they are. And right now, you ought to claim your blessing even before the blessing is manifested. You ought to claim your blessing right now in 2020 before you hit 2021. You ought to claim your blessing right now. Prepare, prevail, now praise. Y'all not helping me. I said prepare, prevail, now praise. Right now, right now, give the Lord praise. Because it shall be well. Right now, praise his holy name. Because it is well. Hallelujah. In 2021, I believe the Lord will do what he's never done before. I believe the Lord will even outdo himself. So right now, in 2021, I declare, I affirm, I proclaim, it is well. It shall be well. It is well. It is well with my soul. If you believe it, if you receive it, shout yeah. If you believe it, if you receive it, going into 2021, shout yeah. Shout yeah. Oh, shout yeah. It shall be well. It shall be well. But right now, it is well. It's well. Oh, it's well. It's well. It's well with my soul. We pause now to offer this invitation to those who may not know Jesus as Lord and Savior. We pause now to simply give unto you the opportunity to come and give your life to Jesus. Just confess with your mouth that he is the Son of God, that he lived, died, and rose again for your sins. Believe that in your heart. And confess it with your mouth, and you shall be saved. If you have that belief, if you've made that confession, pray with me and simply say, Dear God, I believe your Son Jesus lived, died, and rose again for my sins. And while I have been a sinner, right now, I'm saved. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen, amen, and amen. If you prayed that prayer, if you made that confession, we invite you to become a part of the Antioch Church. Just call us at 210-225-2452. If not Antioch, join a Bible-believing church in your local area so that you might grow and be nurtured in the ways of Jesus Christ. For it is well, it shall be well in 2021.
Peace. my sins.
Sins
have been forgiven.
Forgiven.
No more chains.
No more chains.
Nor fear.
Fear.
My past.
My past
is over.
Is over.
God bless you. As we approach the midnight hour, wherever you are in your home, we ask that you would just stand, and wherever you are, if there's someone with you in your home, someone who lives with you in your home, grab them by the hand. Someone you live with in your home, grab them by the hand as we approach the throne of God. And we say goodbye to 2020 and hello to 2021. Let's go before the Lord in prayer. Dear God, in the name of Jesus, how we thank you for sparing our lives. Thank you for allowing us to make it through the trials and tragedies even of 2020. And while we mourn those who have passed from labor to reward, while we remember them dearly in our hearts, we are thankful, God, that you've allowed us to see another year. Now, God, forgive us of those things which we have done that are not according to your will. We pray, God, that you will prepare us to receive the coming glory. Right now, Lord, we acknowledge, Lord, that much of 2020, we have been crying and weeping and worrying. But now, as we come into 2021, God, we want to be in an attitude of preparation and expectation. We come before you, Lord, asking that you do like you've never done before. God, we pray that you move, that you heal, that you uplift. We pray, God, that you will bring deliverance in 2021. And God, we're not going to wait until we see it with our physical eyes. We claim it right now with our spiritual eyes. And we say, even in this moment, it shall be well. Hallelujah. And even while we say it shall be well, we're claiming the promise in this hour, and we're saying it is well. Yes, it's well within our soul. Thank you now for hearing and answering our prayer. And so we close at this hour to simply say thank you. We're not asking for anything else, Lord. We just want to say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for holding us up. Thank you, Lord, for saving our souls. Thank you, Lord, for being on our side.
thank you, Lord, for your deliverance and your power. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for who you are. And we thank you for what you shall do. In the name of Jesus, in the name of him who died late one Friday, in the name of him who went to a borrowed tomb, in the name of him who stayed there all night Friday and all day Saturday and all night Saturday night, in the name of him who got up on the third day with all power in his hands, in the name of Jesus, we pray and ask it all. And we thank you for a brand new year. We thank you for 2021. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And amen. Amen. Now put your hands together and bless the Lord for a brand new year. Come on, put your hands together in your house. Put your hands together around your table. Put your hands together in your bedroom. Put your hands together and bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord. Yes, I will. I will bless the Lord. Yeah, his praise shall continually be on my lips. My soul shall have a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let's exalt his name together. God bless you. God keep you. Happy New Year. I'm finished, y'all, but Happy New Year! Happy New Year! I feel like giving God some praise for a brand new year. I feel like blessing his name for a brand new year. Come on, Happy New Year! Happy New Year! God bless you. God keep you. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with this people henceforth, now and forevermore. And all of God's people said, amen, 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 and amen. God bless you.
Of your grace.